So I'm trying to figure out where exactly you are. Is there any, like, buildings or landmarks around you?
No, we're out in the forest. It's in the Hancock Forest.
Last weekend's cougar attack exposed a weakness in wireless calls to 911.
It's not as accurate as you might think, especially if you're calling from, let's say, a remote area.
A King 5's Greg Copeland has that story from the King County Sheriff's Office Communications Center.
If you're in King County and you make a wireless 911 call from a smartphone, it goes to one of five different agencies, depending on where you're calling from. Operators here at the Sheriff's Comm Center field dozens of those calls every day.
One of the things that people always say, well, why are you asking me these questions? Why don't you just send someone? Well, I'm asking the questions so I know what to send, how much, and who to send, police, fire, medical.
And ops manager Kathy Pompeo says they need to know where you are. Unlike Uber or Lyft or your favorite food service you dialed up with an app, 911 does not have access to your exact location because wireless companies are not required to provide it.
When somebody calls 911 from a cell phone, we don't immediately have their location.
Once they establish an emergency, they can electronically request an update for your phone information called a rebid. That will give them your latitude and longitude. On Isaac Sederbaum's third call to 911 Saturday morning, this is where the nearest cell tower showed he was. Normally, it's within 300 meters of the exact location, but in the forest, the room for error can be a few miles, which is why 911 operators kept asking Sederbaum and Good Samaritans for more specific information.
So I'm trying to figure out where exactly you are. Is there any, like, buildings or landmarks around you?
No, we're out in the forest. It's in the Hancock Forest.
There are roads, but they don't have numbers on them. They don't have names. There's no street signs.
Better technology and access to your exact location would make for a faster response to your emergency, but it doesn't come without sacrificing privacy. And that is something already being debated.
So you have the big brother watching me piece of it. So it's a fine line, and we have to find where that balance is.
In Renton, Greg Copeland, King 5 News.